Hello, my friends. I am making this video on a Makita 8K7651H model gas-powered cutoff saw. This probably happens in a lot of these kind of machines with a pull cord crank. The pull cord got busted. They tried fixing it in work because it's a tool we use a lot, but they didn't put it back together right. It messed up the spring that makes, you know, the cable retract. So I straightened it out. It is pretty flexible and strong, so don't worry if you have to manipulate it. So this is how the spring should look like and how you need to have all the elements apart in order to put it back together. This is probably the best way to put it all together. I tried doing it, you know, with the cord in, and it's not, you know, it didn't work. And I apologize, it's hard to do it all one-handed. I don't have the extra help. So if you are blessed with children, with a wife, or with just a real good friend that can help you out, I mean, that's awesome. You are so beyond blessed if you have any of that. So here I'm just sliding the cord. I got the hook in first and gently sliding it little by little, sliding, turning, and pushing at the same time. Turning and pushing. And the spring will go in, you know, slowly. It's pretty flexible. It's strong. It won't bust, and it won't jump all in your face. But I mean, of course, you're gonna keep a safe distance between the spring and your eyes. So, I mean, don't have your face all in it. Make sure as you turn it slowly, you're pushing at the same time the spring, and it's just feeding in itself in it. And it's not really that hard, but if you could do it with both hands, it's much faster and easier to get it in there. So as you finish up feeding the spring into the housing, this is approximately how you want it to look. It's slightly warped because I tried it a couple of times one-handed and tried to record it. It's really difficult, fortunately. You know, God blessed us with wisdom and capabilities for a lot of things that we can do on our own. Unfortunately, you know, we all have that need of a suitable helper, of those wonderful children, or those amazing friends, you know, to help us out. You know, we're not made to be on our own. We're not made to be selfish. So, if you are blessed with any of that, you know, God, you know, I hope that lasts forever. And if you're on your own, I'm truly sorry. I know how that feels. You know, I'm a lone wolf. But you know, one day we'll find that person that will truly be interested in us. So I hope this helps. You know, as you have it all set up, you won't feed the cable until you have tension on the spring. You definitely need to have tension on the spring, so when you release it, it'll pull the cord into the pulley. So you're gonna spin it counterclockwise, you're going to hold the tension, and that way when you feed the cable, it'll just pull it into the mechanism. So don't forget, turn it counterclockwise. If not, you're just gonna mess up the spring again.
Okay, my friends, here is the crank all put together for this Makita machine cutoff saw, gas powered cutoff saw. Now just remember, I didn't record how. I guess it's impossible for me at this moment. I only have two hands. But just remember, when you install your spring, you need to have it hooked in order that you can spin counterclockwise from right to left, from right to left. And you need to keep pressure. I tried, spinning it, leaving the pressure from the spring and tightening up this screw, but it didn't hold it in place. So if yours does, great. If not, you can find a way to hold the pressure on this, and you want to line up the hole where the cord is going to come in right in this section here. Okay, so you need to, before you put in the cord, your puller, you need to put pressure on the spring. Enough pressure. You don't want it loose, so you're gonna put plenty of pressure on it. And then when you line up the hole, you're gonna feed your cable in, your cord, and make a little knot on it. I used a little screwdriver to pull it out once I had it in. You can use needle nose pliers. I have these needle nose, but they're pretty rusty. You need a Phillips screwdriver, some pliers. These little thingamajigs are T30s, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. T30s. You can also use a flathead screwdriver. Just be careful. And let's see, I don't know if I can show you this, but you can feel the pressure on the crank. That's how you want it. I'm going to install it and try it out. Okay, my friends, Makita cutoff saw spring crank fixed. It works. Let me see. I don't know if I can show you. But see, we have enough pressure. I could have done a couple of more turns, but it's good. It's good enough for tonight. But let me crank it up. There it is. Time. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay. I hope this helps out. It should be the same method for just about all of the pull crank engines. So have fun.
God bless you, and be kind with your friends. Share the gospel. Read your Bible. Believe in Jesus Christ. Repent of your sins. And don't forget to go to church.